Welcome back, Khonius here. I recently landed in Minden, Nevada, and I thought it would be fun to take a quick tour around Lake Tahoe. I'm flying an Icon A5 Amphibious. Let's go ahead and get started. Take off the parking brake. It's a fun craft, and it's fun that you can land in the water and boat around in it. Okay, I think we can go ahead and lift off. Landing gear up. Flaps up. Beautiful shot with the moon and the mountains.
Normal approach KA527 is type Icon A51 miles north of Tahoe 6800. Request flight following.
KA527 normal approach. Call 7204.
So I'm actually re-recording this flight. I did this the first time and had all the avionics turned off and some other things went wrong. So, this is my second try. Beautiful winter day.
Roger, KA527.
Here in early February. I happen to really love this plane. You can land in the water and use it like a boat. Turn the rudder into a water rudder. Okay, so I would like to get a little closer. Here we've got a harbor. You can see a bunch of houses and satellite ghostly boat images. I wanted to show this view. There we go. Glassy reflections are beautiful. Got some altitude going on. See the Minden Airport I landed at in a previous flight there in the distance. Pretty much like Tahoe. I think the game is a little generous with the amount of water that's showing in the lake with the drought we've been having. Maybe there's one of these little coves where I can land and check out some interesting sights. This one here looks interesting, so maybe I'll try to land here. seems like an okay approach. Not sure what landing, you know, what speed you're supposed to land at in the water, but never had much trouble with being able to do this. Might need to get ready to put the water rudder in place as soon as I hit, put the flaps up. It seems like it's okay. I could probably make a little bit of a turn here, just for safety's sake. Plane feels very in control, very easy to fly. You don't need a full pilot's license, just a sport license to fly this. Alright, I think we're going to come into a nice, gentle water landing. Put the flaps up, and water rudder down. Alright, should be able to steer us back into here easily enough. Wow, this is beautiful. I don't know what this area is called, but the views must be spectacular. Water rudder works really nicely. You can still steer with the air rudder, but just this makes it a little easier to steer at lower speeds. Minor corrections, things like this. I guess it just extends a little piece of metal down into the water or something. I see something down there at the back. I kind of wish I could get out and walk around over here. Zephyr Cove. I've been to Zephyr Cove. I used to work on computers there from time to time. So that's what this area is called. I guess it kind of looks a little bit familiar, the hill there, maybe. It's been a long time. This does look very Lake Tahoe. Maybe some kind of a boat launch over here. Yeah, I really ought to be able to open up the plane and put my feet in the water. Okay, so I don't want to beach us. I'm gonna make a turn here, but this looks very nice. You don't want to go too fast, you don't want to actually get airborne until you're ready to take off, of course. Those mountains are beautiful across the way. Maybe I will in fact take off. Track of the water rudder also.
Normal approach KA527 is type icon A56 miles north of Tahoe 6,400 feet. Request flight following. Walk 6537 KA527. KA527 radar contact 6 miles north of Tahoe 6,700 feet. I'll give it a 2 and I heard you. Roger KA527.
Just just enjoying all the views. Oops. And the reflections. Go check out the other side of the lake. There's a water area there on the far right, which is to the left of us as we're going. Not sure what that is. I know there's something called Emerald Bay, I think, around here, but I'm not sure if that's it. And I see some kind of a waterway over here. Just an extension of the lake. Go check this out a little bit. That button's a little sticky, or noisy. Try that again. There we go. Huh? Yeah, maybe I'm hitting it wrong. Try to ignite the finger. Okay, there we go. Yeah, just a little noisy though. I might want to get in there and do something about that. I haven't been super happy with my Thrustmaster controls. They seem a little on the cheaply made side. Might invest in something a little bit better. This is really pretty with the little rock island in the middle. I could come in for a landing here and check it out close up. Flaps are going to give out at the last second, so I do need to have a little bit of thrust going if I want to have a soft landing. I think this will be alright. A little bouncy in the water, that's okay. Put the water rudder down. Wow, this is really, really pretty in here. Flaps up, of course, we don't want to take off unexpectedly. Looks like a skiing ridge or two around here. I wonder if this is camping or something, I don't know, or maybe it's off limits. I want to make sure I really did put the water rudder down. Let's see. Yep, looks like it. Again, if you could just get out and hike around a little bit up there, it'd be really nice.
Normal approach, generic X-ray Sierra IK 3 is passing 16,300 feet, descending 12,000 feet. Generic X-ray Sierra IK 3, normal approach, altimeter 29er, decimal 9er, 2, continue type A as planned.
Maybe if they add jetpacks to the game, you could kind of use that to get around them. Definitely look like a ski slope up there. Looks like you could ski right into the water if you weren't careful. Or is that too steep? I don't know. It looks kind of scary, to be honest. This giant rock island, teeny-weeny from the lake itself. Retracting the water rudder, I can actually see the thing lifting up. Flaps down. And let's take off. Seems like it'd be really fun to have one of these.
Normal approach KA527 is type icon A57 miles northwest of Tahoe 6,400 feet.
Yeah, I guess every time you pop up in the air, you are supposed to radio something.
Normal approach. Squawk 7744.
Squawk 7744 KA527.
So don't plan to tour the whole lake. I think it pretty much looks a lot like this. If I see anything else that looks interesting, maybe those snow-capped mountains across the way. I'm kind of surprised there isn't an air harbor here. Although they do have the airport I took off from, which is the Lake Tahoe Airport. And I do still need to be climbing. Don't know how much fuel this thing holds, how long you can stay up. I've got it set to unlimited fuel, of course. Again, trying to fly the airplane from a funny angle. Okay, I'm going to climb just a little faster. Get up to that mountain top. Wonder if I can land up there. Would be interesting to try to find a flat area to land. This thing's light enough to be able to climb at a pretty fast rate. Trying to steer while looking backwards and doing it the wrong way. That altimeter is very super easy to read at a quick glance. That's probably true of the other ones once you get to know them. Some of them I get into the plane and I have a very hard time telling how high I am. Those mountains are still pretty far up there. I don't know how much I can safely climb in this thing. There we go, 15 degrees. We're gonna stall soon. Yeah, level off. Build some speed up again. Somebody very close by. Trying to see if I can look back and see them. There they go. Don't really need to be turning. Looks like we're doing well in terms of altitude. I don't know what the upper limit of this plane is, but probably about here. I'm starting to lose some speed as we climb. I just engage autopilot. Oh, that's right. I'm going to autopilot. I'm going to be able to engage autopilot. I wonder if we're losing speed because the plane just simply can't go any higher due to, I don't know, air density or something. It's nice to get this kind of an overview of this part of the lake though. Managed to climb okay. Yeah, I'm not sure what was responsible for that drop in speed. Maybe it's the wind. Maybe I pulled too hard on the stick. we don't have the luxury of the nice Garmin avionics in this plane. And we're continuing to climb, okay. Wind's getting a little bumpy. I think we're kind of level with the mountaintops now. I guess this must be like North Lake Tahoe or something. See more bodies of water, but over there, past those little mountain ridges. Again, it's hard to know if the helium is being generous with the water supply. Yeah, Lake Tahoe is definitely beautiful. I don't want to lose too much altitude, so nose up a bit. Crystal Bay, I've heard of Crystal Bay. I'm not sure I'd really feel comfortable trying to land up here on a flat surface, but I could certainly try it. I see a few possibilities. I'm going to go ahead and put flaps down and slow down a bit. Back to throttle.
Air shuttle 6147, you are 16 miles southeast. Descend and maintain 10,000 feet. Expect vectors, visual runway 16 left approach. Descend and maintain 10,000 feet. Expect vectors, visual runway 16 left approach. Air shuttle 6147.
Expecting to find some flat area that looks comfortable enough to land in at a slow speed. Slow down a bit more, but then slow down. Might want just a little bit more altitude. In Time Village, yeah, that looks like a... I mean, I've definitely heard of that name. These all look like ski slopes. Get this nice zoomed in view from inside the cockpit. I'm not sure where the best place to try landing is. Maybe in that depression or that little valley there. Maybe just past it and kind of up the hill a little bit. That's what I'm going to do, is put the flaps down all the way, drop the throttle, and start gliding a bit push on the stick because I was trying to push up. And
Air Shuttle 6147, you are 700 feet above your assigned altitude.
This does seem to be. Of course, there's this valley down here. I wanted to land though near the mountain peak. So while I could go towards the right to the little bit of water, I think I'll stay here. See if I can get a reading for how close I am to stuff. Okay, throttle all the way down. Yeah, I really don't know what's going to happen, but that recent, Trevor Jacob video got me thinking about making emergency landings, so why not give this a try? I feel like somewhere in here it ought to feel a little safe to put down. I was also watching a Trent Palmer video where he landed on a round uphill going mountain. It was a beautiful landing. I never thought anybody would do something like that. It looked amazing. So it kind of inspired me to try this. Yeah, I don't know if this is crazy, if I'm okay. I feel pretty relaxed about this, like it ought to be okay. I'm just not sure exactly where I'm planning to put down. I see an area above. I'm gonna give it some thrust and head for this kind of flat spot right ahead of us. Don't really know how close I am from the ground. Don't have any good visual references other than just the trees. I'm getting a stall warning because of the angle I'm at. Okay, well that was not a good landing. now we're rolling somewhere. So I would not call that a success. I don't know if that's survivable or not. That would probably be a pretty bad crash. So I don't have damage turned on. Anyway, that was kind of fun. Getting into crashing and things going awry is one of the things I want to get into. Having the engine cut out on me and having to find a way to deal with it, that kind of stuff. We'll just let the plane keep doing its thing here. Oh my god, this is funny. It's probably going to just keep rolling down the hill. You know, you'd hope to have climbed out by now. Honestly. I want to see where it stops. I could almost take off again at this point. No, this is not good. I think it's upside down. Yep. There we go. Alright, well, funny way to end a video, but we'll end it here. Let me shut the plane down. First of all, turn the engines off. Okay, that was quick. And shut the plane down. There we go. Thank you so much for watching my crazy crash landing tour of Lake Tahoe. Don't forget to share, like, and subscribe. And I'll see you in the next video.